Hi everyone, this is Sunny Kumar from Mathematics and Computing, IIT BHU, and I am back again with another solution of Code Forces Round 697 Division 3 G Strange Beauty. Now, before proceeding, let us see the time limit. As you can see, time limit is 5 seconds, which makes us comfortable somewhat. Now, you can say we have been given an array of n elements. And the beauty of the array is defined as if at least one of the conditions must meet. So the beauty of array is defined as for every pair of I or j where I and j are indexes, ai is divisible by aj or aj is divisible by ai. So the array is beautiful only if all the pairs of indexes I and j such that there are no pairs of indexes I and j such that ai is not divisible by aj or aj is not divisible by ai. So we have to, what we are going to do, so he wants to remove some elements from the array so that to make it beautiful. Now the question says that we have to remove some of the elements from the given array such that all the pairs of indexes I and j there will be ai is either divisible by aj or aj is divisible by ai. So we have to print the answer. Minimum number of elements that must be removed to make the array beautiful. Suppose here this is, now let us understand this question mathematically. Okay, now suppose I have taken this example from the problem statement. Now suppose we have been given this array. Now for better visualization, let's sort this array. Now we have to remove every pair of I and j such that neither ai is dividing aj nor aj is dividing ai. Now you can see there is a subset of the array elements which is beautiful, like 3, 9, 63. Now you can see that every pair of I and j dividing either of them. Suppose we take 3 and 9, 3 is dividing 9 and or 9 is dividing 3, 9 is not dividing 3, so 3 is dividing 9. Now suppose we take 9 and 63, so for the array to be beautiful, every pair of I and j must satisfy either one of the conditions. So what are the conditions? Either ai is dividing aj or aj is dividing ai. Okay, so suppose this is a subset of the array, so you can easily check that for every pair of I and j, ai is either dividing aj or aj is either dividing ai. So the array is sorted. We can easily check 63 is dividing 63 also, 3 is dividing 9 also, 9 is also dividing 63. So every pair of ij is either dividing each other. So we can say that this array is beautiful. Okay, now how can we construct this array? So the main idea, the main logic behind this question is that pick up the minimum element and mark all the multiples of it, increment all the multiples of it by their occurrence. Suppose we have a given, given array this which is already sorted. So what we are going to do is we are going to pick 3 and we are going to iterate for the multiples of 3. That would be 6, that would be 9. So whenever now you can see that when we encounter 9 which is already present in the array this, what we are going to do, that we are going to calculate. So let me mention here that, okay, you can calculate maximum beautifulness of the array. So if we can, let's say it is array answer, let it say answer 1. So our answer will be n minus ans 1. So because our answer will be n minus answer 1, because if the maximum beautifulness is 1, we have to calculate the minimum number of minimum number of elements to be removed to make the array beautiful. So minimum number of elements to be removed, so that for this to be done, we have to calculate the what would be the maximum beautifulness of the array. So what we are going to do, we are going to pick 3 and we are going to mark all its multiples, and when we encounter the multiple which is already present in the array, we are going to increment a position, increment its position by its occurrence. So what we are going to do is, we are going to initialize a DP linear matrix, sorry, we can't say matrix, DP array. So what we are going to do is, we are going to initialize a DP vector, which would be like, okay, 0, 0. So this is for 1, this is for 2, and this is for 3. 0, 1, 2, and 3. Now this is for 3. So what we are going to do is, we have 3. 3 has already occurred here. So we are going to increment its position by 1. And what we are going to do is, we have already occurred 7, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I guess 7 is here. So we are going to increment its position by the number of occurrences in the array. Suppose 7 has occurred too, so we are going to increment 7 by, increment 7th position by 2. I guess 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh, I'm going to increment 7th position by 2, and I'm going to increment 9, 14, 63 for the 7th, 8th, 9. Okay. Now for afterwards here, I'm going to leave it to yourself. So what we are going to do, we are going to pick 3 which has already occurred, and we are going to mark its multiples with its occurrence in the already given array. Suppose 3 is marked as 1. Now what we are going to do is, we are moving 3 to the 6 that is here, and we are going to mark this as 1. Sorry, we are going to mark this as number, what would be the maximum value that is going to occur at 6th position. The maximum value that is going to occur at ith position, DP of jth position would be maximum of DP of jth position which is already present, suppose, and DP of ith position, that is, suppose we are moving with 3, 6, we are moving in multiples of 3. So we are doing like DP of I, that is maximum value that can occur at jth position which is the multiple of 3 here in this case. So it would be like deep maximum of DP of j comma DP of I plus occurrence of what would be the occurrence of jth position, that is, if we are moving with multiple of 3. So here let us suppose j equal to 6. Okay, so DP of j, maximum position, maximum value at jth index in the DP vector would be maximum of DP of j already present, DP of j comma DP of I, which is the number of occurrence for which we are moving for its multiple, that is DP of I plus occurrence of j. Okay, so this would be our, what we call this as, maximum beautifulness that we can get for jth position. Okay, this is the maximum beautifulness that we can get for jth position. So also this is for 3. Okay, now we can also do for 7, we can also do for 9, mark its multiples further. Now you can easily observe that what is this OCCJ and DP of I. So let me make it clear, OCC of J for any jth position would be number of occurrences of एलिमेंट ए आई एलिमेंट ए इन एंड डीपी ऑफ जे डिफाइन्स द डीपी स्टेट सच दैट डीपी ऑफ जे विल डिनोट द मैक्सिमम ब्यूटीफुलनेस वी कैन गेट एट द डेथ पोजिशन. ओके सो दिस इज फॉर सपोज आई हैव टेकन थ्री एंड नाउ इफ वी आर मार्किंग द मल्टीपल्स ऑफ थ्री देन इट गोज लाइक वेन इट इनकाउंटर 63. So what would be like, it would be like something, let me define dp of 63 equal to maximum of what we can get if at 63th position, what would be the maximum beautifulness we can get, would be maximum of dp of 63, which is 0 obviously, plus dp of I, what would be the value of I, which is here I is 3 because we are marking a multiple of 3. So what would be 3 here? DP of 3 would be here something DP of 3 plus occurrence of 63 in our actual array. So it will give DP of 63 as maximum of DP of 63 which is 0 comma DP of 3 which is 1 plus occurrence of 63 which is 1, so it would give as 2. Okay, now but maximum beautifulness ending with 63 is of length 3, so this is so I have iterated this complete for 3. Now what we are going to do, we are again moving further to 7, then we are moving further to 9, then we are moving further to 14, and for each I belongs to 0 to n minus 1, we are going to mark its multiples with the help of this DP relation. So when we encounter 9, what we are going to do is, suppose a of I is going to be 9. Okay, now what we are going to do is we are going to mark its multiples, that is 9, 18. 18 is not present in the array. So we are moving further. When we encounter 63, then what would be happen? DP of 63 would be maximum of DP of J. DP of 63 again, comma DP of what would be DP of 9 plus occurrence of what? Occurrence of 63 in our array. Now you can easily see that here DP of 9 is the maximum beautifulness, maximum beautifulness we can get ending with 9. So what would be the maximum beautifulness we can get ending with 9? So we can easily see that maximum beautifulness we can get ending with 9 is 2 of length 2. So here DP of 63 DP of 63 would be maximum of DP of 63, which has already been calculated by the multiple of 3, which is here you can see. So DP of 63 already has a 2 value, so maximum of 2 comma DP of 9 which is already 2 plus occurrence of 63 which is 1. Okay, so what will be the value this relation will give. So this relation will give 3. So we can say that maximum beautifulness ending with 63 is of length is of length what? 3. So we can easily say that, so we are going to do this for every element of the array already present. Now one thing you can note, that dp of j must be initialized with the maximum value that the array can hold. That is, in this question you can see that maximum value goes to 2 into 10 power 5, so dp matrix must be like 2 into 10 power 5 plus 5, and similarly the occurrence matrix stores the occurrences of the array of element. So suppose here if we'll have 2 7 present here in this array, then occurrence of 7 would be 2. So this can be noted easily. So this question can be easily solved with the help of dynamic programming, as I have explained. So it is actually basically the extension of sieve of Eratosthenes logic, because in that logic we are also actually marking the prime numbers with the multiples of actually 2 3 5. So we are marking multiples of 2 3 5 as false. So here in this case also we are not marking the multiples, just we are increasing the multiples with the pre-calculated values. So let us move to the code section of the below, understand the how we can implement this. Okay, now easily you can see the accepted code here. Now there are the tests that you can see. Okay, now here you can see I have taken a maximum of 2 into 1e power 5 plus 5 for simplicity, as I have already told you. Now answer is initialized as 0. So we are calculating, we are storing answer as maximum beautifulness we can get, so that we can finally print n minus answer, which would be the minimum answer we are going to print. Now n is the length of the array, and dp would be our dp array, and vec is going to store the occurrences, and store is going to store whatever the elements we are having in the array. So whenever we encounter, we are taking an input, we are incrementing dp of a plus plus and vector of a plus plus. Vector of a is actually the occurrences, dp of a is the base case. Actually let us say, suppose dp of here is the dp values. As here you can see, I have initialized 3, occurrence of 3 is 1, so I have initialized dp with the positions of 3 as its occurrence, 7 as its occurrence, 9 as its occurrence, 14 as its occurrence. So dp is initialized with the occurrence of the values that occur in the array with its occurrence in the array. So I am going to iterate for I equal to 1 to less than num, which is the maximum value, and if dp of I exists, which tells us that if dp of I exists, means if there is an element which is present in the array, suppose we have 3, 7, 9, 14 and 63, so the values will be, when dp of I is true, that is when we encountered 3, 7, 9 and 63, then we are going to mark its multiples I into 2 from starting from 2, and we are incrementing every time plus I, and what we are going to do is we are going to apply this relation dp of j equal to max of dp of j comma wake of j plus dp of I. Wake of j is basically the occurrence, and dp of I is the multiple which we are marking. As you can see here, dp of j would be maximum of dp of j, which is the current value, comma dp of I, which multiple we are going to mark, plus occurrence of j. So we are going to do this for every value that is present in the array. Now what we are going to do, so what are the values that are actually present in the array which we are storing in the store vector? So we are going to iterate in the store vector, and we are going to find the maximum value that we can get ending with maximum beautifulness we can get ending with that array value. So our answer would be max of answer comma dp of it. So finally answer would store the maximum length of beautifulness that we can get. So minimum number of elements that we have to delete would be n minus answer, and we have to print that answer. So basically this question was a interesting one. So actually I've got one time limit exceeded, then I modified something. Now the question is basically of the form DP, math and the number theory. So the time limit is 5 seconds, which made some sort of easiness, which brought some sort of easy to our program. So thank you for watching this video. So if you have any doubts, do mention in the comment section of the video, and I will ask the viewers to like this video, share this video, and do subscribe to my YouTube channel for latest updates. Thank you for watching this video.